I was so proud to be an Italian American growing up in New York, in upstate New York, because we had a big Italian community, and with all different kinds of other nationalities around us, it was very, very giving. Everybody was like a family, whatever nationality you were. So it was kind of a unique experience.
That's a new aspect to the discussion of what we called Italian American studies as opposed to Italian diasporic studies. So that's our goal, and I think we succeeded last year, and I'm sure we're going to succeed this year.
Your rooms are what they are. You have air conditioning. You have hot water. You have your own bathroom. And you even have a television. Tutti cosissimi water. I don't know what else to say. So,
my name is Judy. I am lucky enough to be the spouse of Mary Jo Bona.
Woohoo!
And by virtue of that, I have an appreciation for all things Italian, although I am neither academic nor a writer nor of Italian American descent.
Since we're going over parts of Italy we're from, my mother is from Abruzzo, my father is half from Frosinone, one quarter from Puglia, and one quarter from Salerno. In Frosinone, Sette Frate, and my mother's mother is from Introdacqua in the province of Sulmona, and her father is from Corvara, which is in Chieti, and Cugnoli, which is in Pescara.
Wow, that's nice.
And migration and issues of prejudice and discrimination towards Italian migrants in the late 19th, early 20th century. And I was doing, not unconsciously, a comparative to the rhetorics that are going on in the United States today with Muslims and Mexicans. And it looks like I'm gonna be working more and more on that. And my work that I did as a PhD student has to do with globalization, migration, multi-ethnic literature. So this dovetails nicely. The other thing that I'm still contemplating is because my work is a lot on women authors and ethnic authors, is a book project on somehow bringing together Italian-Scottish women writers with Italian-American women writers and Italian women writers. But that seems like a beast right now. It seems like a much bigger project that I need to think more about and do more work around. And I think that this particular seminar session will help me to think about the ways that I want to approach that, what sort of methodologies I want to use to get there. But I also think that the first project is something that I'll be able to get a lot of work done while I'm here. So.
Idea in the sense that it is really, really complicated, and I really spend most of my time trying to analyze and see how fragile this whole idea is, especially what is, you know, Italian hyphen no hyphen American or Canadian, when we'll be looking at, for example, deep racism between white Italians and black Italians, and how that really influenced and how certain Italians, you know, would actually be hired in order to substitute other Italians who were on strike, and usually geographical situation would be part of it. And the but we will be focusing in my section specifically on what happened in Canada, which is on the other hand very, very different from what happened in the United States, because unlike the United States, the idea of the melting pot, we have multiculturalism, but multiculturalism can also be a cage.
Yeah. I'm adjuncting at the American University of Rome and at Iowa State University College of Design programs in Rome at the moment. And I work on women artists in the early 20th century, predominantly futurist women artists. Studying that topic became very apparent to me that there was a tremendous amount of transnational influence, both of futurism on South America and of many other cultures on Italian futurists. And so it started to be of greater and greater interest to me as I was working on this topic. So currently I'm working on a book on that subject, and I think this will be of use both on that project and on a future project, which I hope to kind of come out of this. So.
Write some poems that I like to write sometimes about what I am at this point in my life. So hopefully I will also like to contribute that as a my own project. Hopefully it's something.
I'm a public historian, most recently working on digital history projects, including one with Joan on ethnic and neighborhood history in Philadelphia. And so this, just the Italian American diaspora studies, is something I've done on my own. It's kind of informally, so this is nice to have a structures that form a way to do it in a place like this.
Tried to hold on to their heritage culture through language, through cuisine, through religion, you know, through other cultural artifacts, right? The second generation is the generation that says, I have to assimilate. So they try to sort of throw out or jettison the first generation's concern about maintaining cultural identity. And they say, we're not interested in that, we want to become Americanized, we're being influenced by media advertisement, by working outside the home, etc., by the school, the institution of the school. The third generation says, again, this is just a schema, the third generation says, I don't know what's wrong with you, mom and dad, second generation, but I like grandma and grandpa, yeah. Right?
There are so, themes of that.
But
one thing we have to think about is that from Italy, don't live just Italians, people with Italian citizenship, but also the migrants.
Yeah.
When we speak about immigration, and which is scaring everybody, migrants are not a good you have forever. Migrants may choose. Nowadays more than in the past, probably, for example, with the police. And so what's happening in Italy is that migrants started to live with the police.
Culture in Chicago through his work, this place called Villa Scalabrini, which when I was a kid, the Italian Cultural Institute Center was a seminary, a Sacred Heart Seminary.
And my uncle had a little grocery store and a little bakery. And my father started playing around and he started to make the homemade breads like they make them over here. And all of a sudden, people were asking for it, you know. So we got into the baking business, and I was probably delivering to his house because we started to deliver bread from house to house. That's how we started our business.
Turner, there are these couples, there are opposite couples, always, almost always, in Peter Dallas' book. But, as I said, this is also the basis of the theory of the humor. The opposition, the false opposition, the real opposition. Right? So, Ninfarosa is the opposite of Maria Grazia. And please note the names, which is Pirandello always uses in a very creative way, the names of the characters. Maria Grazia, Mary Grace in English, is the name of the Madonna. No? Ninfa Rosa, it's a pagan name, Ninfa, nymph, is the same word. So one is a Christian name, the other one, no, it's a pagan name. One is the mother. Let's go now. Directly in the character. So Maria Grazia is a mother, who's here as the mother. And in her character, there is the cliché of the mater dolorosa. I'm laughing and saying that.
Into the migration progress based on the social ideological spaces they in turn navigating, pun intended. In general, this group were less fatalistic or apocalyptic enough to leave about leaving the land and were necessarily better equipped to enter and explore the so-called new world. From these groupings, one can begin to study the variety of diasporas that were created, because there were a variety of diasporas that we created, and we can talk about this later, which ones they were and why is this important. And it's not the case, of course, I'm not saying that there weren't professionals or intellectuals among them in their midst. It's just that they ended up, they do represent a minority of the immigrants, okay, numerically.
Society are multicultural and provides a plurality of identities, making offers that are part of our daily life. So it is a dynamic, interactive, and transnational context.
How all these diasporas connect and the focus is on what's happening in Italy now, on what's happening in southern Italy especially, but not only where we are right now, you know, in this location. And Sicily is just down there, you know, it's not far from here. It's an island, but it's very close to the mainland, to Calabria. The Messina Strait is right there, separating or uniting these two big pieces of land, because Sicily is really very big, you know, more than you think of.